Hey, what's going on? This is Sarah Lee Day, and you're watching Dubsado Tidbits, the things you need to know about Dubsado delivered in bite-sized pieces. Today, we're going to talk about kind of a technical setting that you can set in your Dubsado. It's called domain names. And what that does is it actually helps with branding your forms so that the URL shows your domain name versus the Dubsado domain name. And let me show you what I mean by that. So in our trial account, if we go over here to the form section, which we haven't talked about yet, but this is just to kind of show you what I'm talking about. This lead capture, if we were going to share this and we wanted to send a direct link to somebody, the link is currently going to say hello.dubsado.com and then the rest of the form information there. What we can do is we can actually change this to be something else dot your domain name.com. So it could be you could leave it as hello dot. You could change it to portal dot your domain name.com. You could change it to clients. Basically, you have the ability to customize what this URL looks like and include your actual website domain name in it so that it's fully branded to you and your business instead of having Dubsado in there. Now, to do that, we're going to come up here to the gear icon, click on domain names on the left, and we're going to follow the instructions on here to fill in that information and to actually redirect the traffic that goes to that form through a URL that has your domain name on it. Now, remember, I said this was a technical setting, so don't be scared. It is technical, but there are some really good instructions here, and there is a really good tutorial on Dubsado's Help Center. So the first thing you're going to do is you're going to go to your domain host. So whoever is hosting your website, a lot of people use SiteGround and Bluehost. Those are a couple of the ones that are out there. There's a lot of different ones. So depending on the one that you're using, you're going to have to go into their settings and figure out, where to do this information. But once you get in there, you're going to create what's called a CNAME record. And for that CNAME record, let's say for example your website was example.com, the CNAME that you're going to put in there is portal or hello or clients or whatever you want it to be in that first part of your URL, dot example or dot your domain name.com. And then you're going to point that CNAME to this right here, ssl.dubsado.com. And all that information is going to be within your domain host. So this is not in Dubsado, it's in your domain host. Now, truth time here, early on in my business, I decided to sign up with a hosting platform on a long-term plan that is not the best. I'm not going to point out who it is, but they are just not the best. So I actually cannot set this up for my own business. So unfortunately, I'm not going to be able to walk through how that setup looks, for example, in the hosting that I have. But like I said, Dubsado does have a good tutorial that you can look at. Once my hosting expires and I get to transfer to a new host, I will do another video that covers that. But for now, you're going to have to kind of do this on your own or get some help. And this is something that, if needed, I can actually help walk you through. We can do a screen share looking at your actual host information if that's something that you need help with. In the meantime, so that's step one. Step two, you're going to verify that URL that you basically just created. Then what you're going to do is you're going to put in whatever your CNAME was and your domain name. So if you chose portal, let's just say, then you would put in portal dot whatever your domain name is dot com and then click over here to verify it. It's going to take about a minute or so to complete, so just be patient, let it go. Once that's complete, you will get a confirmation message. It'll come up and say, it was successful. And then you can come down here to the URL meta information. And what this is I don't know if you've ever noticed, but when you click on something or you share something on social media, it comes up with an automatic like page title and description. And sometimes you may wonder, like, where did that even come from? Well, this is where that's going to come from when you're sharing Dubsado forms on your social media. So if you want to create a page title and a description here, Just keep in mind that these are going to show for every single form, so you don't want to make it too specific. Make it more generic to your brand. So a page title here for this trial company might be Tidbits Innovations. That's the company name that I've created for this. And a small description, the things you need to know about Dubsado delivered in bite-sized pieces. Now, if we wanted to put a preview image and a favicon image, we could do that. This will be the main image that appears when sharing a link. And this would be if they were decided to favorite that link, what that icon would look like. So if we wanted to add, say, our logo here as a preview image, we could do that. And that would be the image that shows when they're sharing. Now, for the favicon, you want to make sure that it is a 16 by 16 size. And if you don't have one, don't worry about it. It's not a necessary element. Make sure after you've done all of that you go up and save your changes. And that should do it. So now, whenever you share your links to forms or your lead capture or any of the links inside Dubsado, anytime you share them, they're going to come up with that CNAME. So if it's portal or hello or clients or whatever, dot your domain name, dot com, and then the rest of the link for that specific form. All right, that's it for today's tidbit. For more information about receiving updates, requesting future episodes, or getting help with your own Dubsado account, check out the links in the description below this video or visit saraleeday.com. Thanks for watching. Have a good one.